Americans around the country have been using the town hall meetings to voice their opposition to the Democrats' health care bill. Now, Katy Abram is just one of those Americans, and she joined us right here last week. And after she got up and told Senator Arlen Specter just why Americans are so angry, well, it didn't take long for the liberal attack machine to go into full gear. Now, they even took a shot at us for having Katy right here on this program. Here's alleged comedian John Stewart's take on that event.
One woman at Arlen Specter's latest death match asked such an emotionally charged question, she became Sean Hannity's new Joe the Plumber.
This is about the systematic dismantling of this country. You have awakened the sleeping giant. We are tired of this. This is why everybody in this room is so ticked off. I don't want this country turning into Russia, turning into a socialized country.
Okay, well, good for you. I think that's incredibly hyperbolic fear, but you got to voice... You got to voice your question in a calm way to your senator. You can't argue with that.
Katy, were you happy with the answer that you got from the senator today?
Honestly, after I asked the question, I was so just, I don't know. I didn't hear half of what he said, to be honest with you.
Great. Welcome to Fox. Can you start on Monday?
And that's not all. The left-wing blogosphere went in overdrive, accusing Katy of everything from stupidity to racism. Now, the blog White Noise Insanity argued, quote, that with a black man in the White House, she's just feeling like the founding fathers would be livid because they wanted white power to the end. The website Crooks and Liars charged that, quote, Abram isn't a professional pundit, but when questioned, it became clear that she is the poster child for the undereducated, underinformed mob that make up the right-wing town hall protesters. Lovely. I guess the tone in Washington really changed. And joining me now to respond to all of this is Katy herself. Katy, you're laughing. Now, there has been an onslaught. Uh-huh. And this is why I wanted to have you back. You have been under fire from the second you took on Senator Specter. And it's been personal. How bad has it gotten for you?
It's been interesting. The people that have supported me far outweigh those who have been sending hate mail and everything. I just have to laugh seeing this because I haven't seen this. I've been trying to kind of shield myself from it.
Which is very smart, by the way.
Yeah, definitely. I'm like, okay, I'm undereducated and all these awful things. But you know what? Like, I've had so many people say to me, you know, you need to keep saying what you've been saying. You're speaking for me. You're speaking from your heart. The reason a lot of people don't say anything is because they're terrified this thing's going to happen to them. Mm-hmm. And honestly, bring it on. I don't care because this is too important. This is bigger than me. This is bigger than my family. This is our country.
You know what's amazing, though? I mean, one person, and I was very impressed when you got up there and you said, I'm a stay-at-home mom. I have not been politically active my entire life. Mm-hmm. But the fact is you went there. It's not an easy thing to do to speak in public. Were you nervous?
Yes.
Okay, right?
Extremely.
When you said to me, for example, and John Stewart is making fun, part of it is because you're in the moment there and it sort of consumes you, no?
Well, that's the thing. You know, here I am, and Arlen Specter's right next to me. You see him on TV all the time. I've never met the man before. And I had been thinking about this for, I guess, about 2 weeks maybe since I had gotten the invitation in the mail. And for whatever reason, knowing that I was going to be able to hopefully go ask him a question just kept me up at night, literally. It's like, if I get the chance, what am I going to ask him, you know? And then here's the opportunity to do it. And I got, you know, caught up in my question, and then people are starting to cheer inside the room. I didn't expect that. I was just going to ask my question. I was going to go home. I was going to paint my living room and, you know, do some other things.
And raise my kids.
Yeah. And, you know, it's like I've been kind of thrown into this national spotlight. And a few times I've questioned myself of whether or not to go through with this, but my kids came home from them being away for a week, and I hugged them, and I was like, this is the reason why I have to do this. Mm-hmm. I don't want them to have to be paying for this for years and years. It's just not worth it.
Well, what do you make of, now, we've watched all these politicians attack. We see how Governor Palin's treated. We saw how George W. Bush is treated. Mm-hmm. This is the first time, though, American citizens are being attacked by a party. Are you part of a mob? Are you a political terrorist? Mm. Do you like Tim McVeigh?
No.
Any sympathies towards the Nazi Party?
No.
No racist views in your life?
No.
No. What do you think when prominent Democrats have been making these charges?
I think it's ridiculous. I've heard Nancy Pelosi saying about how, you know, we're mob and swastikas and all that stuff. I'm sorry. I'm stay-at-home mom. I take care of my kids. I'm doing what I'm supposed to be doing. And you've got these people that are in charge of the country calling the people of this country awful names.
Yeah.
Awful names. I mean, my original question to Arlen Specter was going to be, I want you to denounce what Nancy Pelosi has said to about the people of this country. It's ridiculous.
Yeah.
It's ridiculous.
Well, as you, for example, we're trying to spend a lot of time on this program to inform the American people. You're dead on. It's not, there's no hyperbole here. This is socialism, where the government's taken over our banks, mm-hmm. the government is attempting to take over health care, our financial institutions, they're dictating pay, and they're spending worse than drunken sailors.
Yeah.
So you're seeing all this going on. Tell me from your, you know, your heart and your perspective, you know, what you think, why you think the country's headed down the wrong road.
I think the problem is this. Benjamin Franklin had said that compassion can be counterproductive. And I'm a compassionate person. I you know, we give money to different charities. I volunteer at church. And what can happen is compassion, well, he said that compassion that allows a drunk to increase his drunkenness is counterproductive. Compassion that allows weakness and dependence is counterproductive. And all these things that the government's been doing over the years, completely counterproductive. And it's taking the drive out of people. I mean, if you have two hot dog stands, my friend Karen told me this. She's like, if you have two hot dog stands, you got a $2 hot dog over here and a free hot dog over here, which line are you going to go to? I'm going to the free hot dog line.
I'm going to the $2 one, so I don't have to wait online. That's where I'm going.
But it's easy, and I don't blame the American people for know that take it, that use these programs because they're there. But when another one is implemented, once the government puts their fingers in everything, you can't take that out.
Katy, I want to just tell you, I think the reason that you've been under fire is because what you said to Arlen Specter resonated, and it was very effective. So congratulations. Welcome. Baptism by fire. Welcome to the public arena. And we appreciate you being here. Thanks for coming back.
Thank you for having me.